Hello adventure riders from around the world. About a month ago, I bought this white Aero Commander. During this time, I have made a number of different tests, and today in this video, I plan to share my opinion about the model. So if you have nothing to do, you can grab a beer and of course, stay with me. Welcome back. If you don't know me, my name is Pavlin and I am a motorcycle traveler. In this channel, I usually upload anything related to long motorcycle trips, so you might consider subscribing. Back to the topic, how good is the white IROC? Before I even start, just to let you know that I am not sponsored from IROC. I bought this helmet with my own money. It cost me exactly 300 euros or around $367. Here, in this point, I expect many of you to say, Pavlin, listen, IROC is a decent quality. There are so many different brands and models much better than IROC. I perfectly understand this as well. But this model and this brand is something that I can afford and it has a decent quality. Also, I have a very special opinion about expensive helmets and let me support it with a few specific reasons. Number one, my helmets usually last about a year. I've never been so careful with it, usually leave it on the ground, never clean it, never really worry about it, and of course it becomes really visible after a while. Number two, even if I change myself and became really careful owner, the paddings inside after a year get loose and you have to change it or at least clean it. But if you clean it, if you wash it, they became even more loose and anyway you have to change it. And the third reason is that I have to mount my camera somewhere. And most of the time, I almost need to destroy the vents or some different points of the camera just to be possible to mount the holders of the GoPro cameras at the moment. Before that was Contour. So I never want to spend, let's say, 500, 600, 700, 800 euros for helmet and destroy it. These are the three good reasons for me always to buy decent or even low quality helmets because they're just for 1 year. It's not like riding gear. You can have it and ride it for 3, 4, 5, 10 years. But with helmets, it doesn't work for me. There are so many different opinions what helmet you should use. Street, modular or dual sport like this. Of course, this is a personal choice and this is not the purpose of this video. So let me finally tell you my opinion about the model. I will split the review on 5 different categories: price, quality, comfort, functionality, and durability. I will tell you what I think about all of them. Number one is the price. As I told you, I have paid 300 euros, and in my opinion, this is an average price of a good quality helmet. During the years, I have had many different helmets. Some of them were very expensive, some of them were cheap, but they all last about a year. That's why I consider this as a fair price because of the reasons that I just listed a minute ago. Number two is quality. You can see by yourself that the build quality is, I will say, very good. Not decent, very good. The materials are nice, beautiful color combinations. Of course, I choose to have in white because for more visibility, but you can choose any color you like. They all look absolutely great. It has integrated pin lock system, which is good. The sunglasses are big enough. They cover almost all of your nose, which is a big plus. The ventilation is very good and the buttons are big. You can open it with your gloves without any problems. The peak, it has enough length just to provide the necessary shade, but not to make problems while you ride. Of course, when you ride with the speed over 120, 30, 40 kilometers, you might have some kind of buffeting, but I don't ride this speed, so for me, it's fine. The paddings are very good. I did not have any discomfort even for the whole day riding. In total, guys, build quality very good. I really like the shape, this curvy shape here on the rear side, this one here, because it has two different purposes. The very first is to provide this flat surface, so if you have a neck bracelet, it stay exactly on the top and provide the necessary protection that you need, so your head not moving left or right. And the second purpose is when it's rain, it move away, the raindrops away from your neck, which is very, very uncomfortable sensation. Most of you will know what I mean. So build quality, I will say very, very good. Number three is comfort. On the first riding day, or I should say on the first test day, I had it for more than 6-7 hours without even removing from my head. This was absolutely enough for me to understand that this helmet is going to be good. Usually on the first day it's more like adjustment. I need to press here and there. The paddings are sometimes not so comfortable. They're too tight or too loose. It happens a few times I need to remove the paddings on some of the helmets and even press the foam just to make the necessary shape that I have, because a few sharp angles here were annoying me all the time. What with this was absolutely, I put it and that was all. I kept it for the whole day. And it is also very light. I don't know how many kilograms it is exactly. It's at 1510 grams, but you feel it really light. And yeah, comfort absolutely top. Number 4 is functionality. Very easy to use, very good wind and noise insulation because of this optical shape. I told you already about it. Ventilation, as I told you, very easy to control with your gloves. The visor is very good. The visibility from the visor is very nice. It has this wide angle, absolutely perfect. And what I really like here is one feature the visor got. It's like a double locking mechanism. So once you close it, it has another one position that actually locks the visor. Listen now. Now the visor is locked. This is so good because once you lock it, you don't have any wind or noise coming inside, which is perfect. I used to have this in one of my old helmets and I love it. And since then I always miss it. But with this, I have it again. So functionality for me, absolutely perfect. I also like this chin guard or chin cover or protection, whatever the name it is, because it provides this extra wind protection, especially in the cold days. So stop the wind to go under your helmet. And the reason I like it so much, because once I install my microphone in, it will help me to have a better audio, which is a big plus for me. And I plan to keep it even in the summer. That's okay, it might be too hot, but the audio is very important for me, so I'm gonna keep it. So all of this together make functionality perfect for me. Also, there is enough room between my face and the chin. Let me show you. Alright, now you can see how good is the visibility from the visor. Let me open it for you. Of course, this is the view from the camera. Your eyes will see much more than this. But anyway, you can have one idea. What I also like is that there is more than enough room between the chin and my face, so I can actually install a microphone here. I can install two different microphones, one from the camera on the left side and one for my Bluetooth system, which is very good. Let me show you this double lock mechanism of the visor. This is the first position and now is the second. Once you hear this click, this means that the helmet is very well insulated. You're not gonna have any wind or noise. And it will help you, especially when you need to ride for many hours. Let me remove it now. I test the helmet mostly in the cold days on temperatures between 5 and 15 degrees and it works absolutely perfect without any problems. I don't know how it's going to be on the hot days. We're gonna find out. I'll probably make another one long-term review after a year. But even if it's hot, everything that I have seen so far, it's enough for me to keep it. In one of the test days, I have experienced a lot of rain and heavy fog, and the pin lock system did the job just perfect. I have had one very small spot here on the left side with a little fog, but it might be because of the poor pin lock system installations. I have done it by myself and I might be, I don't know, maybe touch it a little bit or made something wrong, but I cannot say any bad words about the pin lock system. It worked. And the last point, number 5, is durability. From everything that I have seen so far, this helmet will last enough. As I told in the beginning of the video, my helmets usually last around a year. If this helmet provides me a 1 year with a good quality, comfort and functionality, I'll be more than happy. Of course, all of this depends from your riding style and how you care about your gear. It might last much longer than this, don't get me wrong. Alright, so far I told you only the pros, but like any helmet on the market, it has some cons. Number one are the padding. I told you that they are very, very comfortable, no doubts about it. But the way they're designed, it's not exactly what I would prefer, especially the locks of the padding. Usually they have a small locks like a buttons and you can press it and lock it, but not this. They have buttons on one side, but on another it has a plastic with an open shape. If you open it, you understand what I mean. I don't want to remove it now just for the purpose of video, because more you remove it, worse is going to be, and after that you cannot have the same shape and the same position of everything, and they will get loose very, very easy. But this is one of the minuses that I have found so far. It is not that bad, but it might be a problem in long term. And one advice from me: if you have an idea to clean the helmet or wash it, please do not remove the paddings. Clean it with some kind of dry cleaning materials. There are so many on the market today. You just spray it and it's get dry and it's absolutely clean, because more you remove it, worse is going to be to put it inside. The second minus that I have found is the mounting points of the Bluetooth system. The one that you've got on both sides to mount the speakers are not deep enough. There is holes over there, but they are not deep enough, and depends of your model, you might need to dig a little bit more to have it on the right position. Otherwise they're gonna press your ears and it will be painful after a while. The third con that I have found, I cannot even consider it as a con, is this double D locking mechanism. Many of you guys hate it. I personally like it, and I consider this as a plus, because this is the safer way to lock your helmet. I really like it. You can tie it whatever you need, you want. So for me this is a plus, but you might be completely different. The fourth is the sunglasses trigger. It's a little bit hard, so you need more pressure to release it. To take it back is fine, but to release it you need more pressure. After a few attempts you already learn how to do it, but the beginning is hard. You really have to press hard, moving actually your head. But after a few attempts it became normal, so even this is not that bad. And the fifth is this chin guard, or chin protection, or chin cover, whatever the name was. It is designed well, but the way it's designed to stay here is not so clever. It has a small like a hooks, and you have to press it, and it's supposed to stay there. But actually every time when you remove your helmet or put your helmet back, it gets loose and you might lose it very easy. This is exactly what happens with me on one of the first days. I lost it. Luckily, on the next day, I found it on the same position that I was a day before, and now I glue it here because I don't want to lose it. And many might say, Pavlin, yes, but the summertime is going to be too hot, better is to remove it, don't glue it. Anyway, I will keep it in the summer because of the microphone that I told you earlier. So guys, these are all of the cons that I have found so far, but as I told you, I'm gonna make another one long-term review, maybe after a year, and I will tell you if I know something else. Meanwhile, if you have any opinions about it, or if you know many more cons or pros, please let me know in the comment section below, because many people will watch this video review and many will read the comments, and they might be beneficial from what you have said. Thank you in advance. In overall guys, I really like this helmet. I really like the quality, functionality, everything that I just told you, and I can highly recommend this to each and every one of you. And now my friend, because you watched the entire video, I have two gifts for you. The first is a free PDF file with the 10 most important things that you have to learn before you decided to go on your next long motorcycle trip. The second is that I will give you the chance to determine the price to one of my books, which is actually mean that you can have it for free. If you decide to spend a couple of dollars, they will be more than appreciated. And of course, if you want to learn but you don't have the time, you might consider joining my online course. It will cost you money, but it will shorten the time significantly, and you'll be able to learn everything you need for only 8 hours. All the links are in the description down below. Always ride safe and see you next time. Ciao.